We're a long way from Rio and more than 2 weeks from Team USA's Olympic debut, but the road to gold begins tonight in Las Vegas, Nevada. You're watching USA Basketball presented by Nike. The U.S. men's team against Argentina as they launch their exhibition season, the first of five exhibition games. We're inside T-Mobile Arena here in Las Vegas. Great to have you with us here on NBA TV. I'm Matt Weiner here with 2000 Olympic gold medalist Steve Smith. And Smitty, the U.S. is set, and we are just about set to go here in Las Vegas.
And you said it best. The two words is program and a pool of players. So many different guys in that select team that they get a chance to choose from, and I think it's fantastic the job they've done, Jerry Colangelo and Coach K.
Argentina wins the tip. Marcos Thelia beats it, and that's Facundo Campazzo. He has some history with the United States we'll touch on throughout the game. Turnover right away, and this is what the U.S. is likely to do very well. Turn it over and give it to Kevin Durant.
Well, you're talking about turning defense and offensively very quickly, and I talked about the versatility. That was just the long arms and wingspan of Kevin Durant deflecting that basketball. But then the speed of this Olympic team, I don't think it'll be matched by any.
He's built like J.J. Barea, better passer than Barea, but not the scorer that Barea is. U.S. is off again. Nocioni lost it. Toes the line for three, and it's good. Andres Nocioni, the 36-year-old, one of those gold medalists from the 04 team. Mello will try the United States' fifth three of the game so far, and the Americans finally hit one.
But when you talk about natural ability to be able to find guys, they don't have a lot of guys. I think you look at Kyrie as a point guard, and then you maybe have a Draymond Green, and then I would say even next is probably DeMarcus Cousins with ability to just to find guys and get them open shots.
And to still at it at the NBA level.
Two-time All-Star, like you said, four-time NBA champion, but just remarkable international player. Gold medal. And he had, like you said, this team rolling, the Argentina team.
Thompson misses it, and DeAndre Jordan is there to clean it up.
I think.
And Jordan has it. He'll get a lot of those.
Above the rim and above the square.
Durant past Scola. Leaves it for Jordan. It's an awkward spot, but throws it down nonetheless. DeAndre Jordan had to gather his feet for a moment.
And this is when you understand the players you play with. Kevin Durant, not used to playing with a guy like DeAndre Jordan because you got to throw it up. But beautiful pass by Kevin Durant. And look at DeAndre Jordan trying to go up. But he gathers and, you know, Mono, be careful with throw.
As you know, Jordan struggles from the free throw line. Campazzo ahead to Nocioni.
And there's
guarded
Kyle
by Kyle Lowry.
Boy, he is walking on the ball with his strength and size.
And Lowry forced to travel on Nocioni. Kyle Lowry's given up about 7 or 8 inches to Nocioni, but he kind of bulldogged him in.
The red, white, and blue. Coach Krzyzewski has won two golds, and throughout that process here, he has said that he has learned he can't coach this national championships. With the professionals, he has stressed no rules in the locker room, yet it is standards where the pros themselves get to decide what the ethics will be for this team. Now, in terms of the immense amount of pressure, Coach K says the style of play helps this team alleviate that pressure to win gold or bust. Fast-paced, everybody getting involved, a lot of defense. And Smitty, the U.S. military, as you know, has played a huge part in having this team understand their selfless service motto. Coach K says not as much pressure when it's great to serve, and they have certainly embraced that.
There. He's watching DeRozan work out after practices with an NBA ball, and I asked him about that. He said it was just to get the feel for it once again. Here's Nocioni for three, a nice look from Lapovitola.
A nice little run for Argentina defensively and also offensively. They're moving around, and yes, they're still down by 10, but a good job by them.
Paul George with the floater. What a great story it is that Paul George, 2 years on August 1st since he came back, and it's interesting, he said he felt better during the playoffs because that's closer to the two-year timeline his doctors gave him for recovery.
Ways come back and return. I think he has a chance, the way he's playing right now, to be an MVP candidate for the Pacers in this league. And there's Cousins again on the offensive glass. What a special talent DeMarcus Cousins is.
A block and a half, roughly. Such a talent. Draymond Green with an offensive board. He gets it back again. The U.S. will get another try. It's George for three.
Man, fantastic job by Draymond, even though the shot was blocked, being able to carve out space and get an offensive rebound, and then in traffic, being able to throw it up and out to Paul George for an easy one. And there's Paul George again.
And Paul George finishes off the quarter nicely for the U.S. 12 second chance points. Paul George led the way in the first quarter with 10 points. He was 4 of 6 from the field, a couple of three-pointers compared to just one for his teammates, as Nocioni drops home the floater.
Nice job by Nocioni knocking that one down. A great pump fake from the line. I think for them is turning over the basketball and being able to keep the U.S. team off the glass. And there's another turnover and run out by Paul George.
Paul George fakes the three again over to Irving.
Oh,
three
this
the
is
shot
beautiful.
Clock. Great ball movement off the front rim and kept alive by DeRozan. Durant will try another three and gets it. More second chance points for the United States, and a three falls.
That was just beautiful basketball. Then being able to slap it out, the offensive rebound, DeAndre Jordan for a three from Kevin Durant.
Gabriel
That's the way you
Deck,
play the game.
Sorry, Gabriel Deck turns it over. Back again, the U.S. Somebody's down a shoe. DeRozan.
Did you see that?
Yes, he
Kyrie
took the shot anyway.
The pass and his shoe to him.
That is an assist. Won't go in the box score that way. Back to DeRozan, who's still working out the footwear. Eventually, Jordan standing below the rim is fouled by Laprivitola.
Kyrie and DeRozan smiling at each other. If we could get a chance to see that again. I mean, he threw his shoe and the basketball to him. I love if he could have caught the shoe and knocked down the shot.
And he managed to get the ball, get rid of it, and then quickly go for the shoe.
You can see DeRozan still smiling. When got his shoe, sliding around a little bit. But before that, Kyrie got a chance to throw the basketball to him.
Laprivitola with Durant on him. Him showing the versatility defensively. That's just unfair. Campazzo for three. It's no good. And Jordan had it. Oh, look out. On the baseline.
Ooh. Camera guy took one.
George made contact with one of the photographers on the baseline. And that is not the guy you want coming
Ooh.
After you. He tried to slow up to protect the fan. Argentina.
I mean, they're switching everything, USA. 1 through 3, not with Kyrie and DeAndre Jordan.
Laprivitola with the left hand. 4 points for Laprivitola. DeRozan out to Irving now, guarded by Campazzo. Here's DeRozan. Shows off the Euro step and high off the glass.
Man, what I love about from that area to still be able to get in and make plays.
Campazzo from the free throw line. Irving has it, pushes ahead to Kevin Durant. And a travel by Durant. And if you've watched the United States in these international competitions.
Usually with the scoop.
Got a scoop. He's got the shoulder shimmies he uses so effectively. Durant starting to feel it here a little bit. Kevin knocks down another three, his second, and he has 10 points. And again, we think Delfino may get some run here tonight. But that group all basically grew up together. You could just see it on the floor how much. That's pretty good.
And both guys regarded at the top of their craft in both divisions, college and NBA.
Ooh. Round and round it went. Eventually cleaned up by DeAndre Jordan. Great scorers in international history. If you look at his points per minute numbers over his international careers, Ginobili knocks it down.
Well, for USA basketball. Look at Cousins.
Butler from the baseline and good.
And Ginobili with the steal, but the quick hands and ability of DeMarcus Cousins to get that steal. It's fantastic.
Jimmy Butler to the free throw line. First time playing with the U.S. national team.
Watch this. Ginobili has it. And look at Cousins being able to catch the basketball and then make two perfect passes. And then Jimmy Butler with the finish and foul. Now they have the ability to be able to press all over the court, especially with DeAndre Jordan.
That part was handled by Argentina, but they couldn't get it past the trap. And Paul George has another
I mean, when you start looking at their percentage, it's not good at 42.3, and a lot of it's easy second chance points. But this is what makes them dominant, the USA team. They can score in so many different ways. And he, like you said, has been in the paint. And there's Manu
at the buzzer. Manu Ginobili. A little Manu magic before the break. But the U.S. leads it by 23. Ginobili's second three of this first half. He has six. But the United States scores 56, 34 of those in the paint, 19 on second chance points.
Matt, he's 38.
He's almost 39.
Almost 39, but he knocks it down. Fantastic for them, but they're still down 23 points. But there's Manu Ginobili, one of the greats. Knock it down at three. That's big.